Transportation in Animals and Plants, Part 1. Circulatory System. Hello friends, do you know that we need food, water and oxygen to stay alive? How does the food, water and oxygen reach the different parts of our body? Have you ever tried to hear your heartbeat? Keep your hand on your chest and try to hear the heartbeat. Have you ever seen the blood vessels on your hands? What is their work? Come, let us go with Sarita and Rama to their school where a doctor has come to conduct a checkup. The objectives of this video are A. To understand what is blood and getting information about its component. B. Getting information about blood vessels.
Children, today a doctor Didi will come from the hospital in the village. She will conduct your annual health checkup.
Okay, teacher.
Shyam is absent today also?
Teacher, I had gone to his house yesterday. He had high fever. His mother told me that his blood tests have been conducted.
Okay. Thank you, Sarita.
Teacher, why has Shyam's blood gone for getting tested?
Rama, sometimes when we are unwell, the doctor get our blood tests done to find out what disease do we have. Come children, now go in pairs and get your checkup done. Rama and Sarita, both of you go first.
Come children, what is your name?
Hello Dr. Didi, my name is Sarita.
Sarita, now you take a long and deep breath. Now give me your hand.
Dr. Didi, can I ask you a question?
Yes, sure, Sarita.
One of our classmates is unwell. His blood tests have been done. Can you tell us why his blood tests were conducted?
Didi, my mother says that if I eat green vegetables, it will help in increasing my blood. I do not like spinach at all.
You girls have a lot of questions. Let us do one thing. Once I finish checking all the students, I shall sit with all of you and answer all your questions. We shall understand about blood and blood vessels.
Dr. Didi checked all the students one by one. Then she collected all the children.
Come children, now all of you are doctors and I am your patient. Rama and Sarita, come here. Take my stethoscope and doctor's coat and conduct my checkup. Wow! Children, all of you are conducting the checkup very efficiently. Today, Rama and Sarita had asked a few questions about blood and its functions. Come, let me answer those.
Dr. Didi goes and gets a poster of the circulatory system from the biology class.
Didi, what are these blue and red pipe-like tubes?
These are the blood vessels and the heart is in the center. Do you know, children, how many times does our heart beat in a day?
No, Didi.
Our heart beats 1 lakh times in a day.
Our heart does a lot of hard work. No doubt it is the strongest part of our body.
Yes, you are right. The heart works like a pump. Because of the pump, blood flows smoothly to all the organs of our body.
Didi, isn't blood a liquid like water?
Yes, children. Blood is a liquid like water. It has different types of cells suspended in it. The fluid part of blood is called plasma. It constitutes 55% of the blood. Plasma is yellow in color.
What about the rest 45% of the blood? What constitutes it? And if plasma is yellow, then how is our blood red?
Didi, my older sister is in 11th standard. She was telling me once that blood constituted of red blood cells.
You are right. The blood has one type of cells known as the red blood cells. They contain a pigment known as hemoglobin. It is because of this pigment that our blood is red.
Similarly, like because of the presence of chlorophyll in leaves, they are green in color.
Very good. It is a wonderful simile, Sarita.
Didi, once I had a lot of weakness and the doctor had said that the level of hemoglobin had reduced in my blood.
Yes, children. Hemoglobin does not only give the color to the blood but also binds with the oxygen and transports it to all parts of the body and ultimately the cells.
The doctor had prescribed me to eat green vegetables and fruits.
Yes, because green vegetables are rich in iron and iron helps in the increase of hemoglobin.
Oh, so this is the reason why my mother asks me to eat spinach. Now I understood.
My sister had told me that along with red blood cells, there are white blood cells also present in the blood.
Yes, children. The blood also consists of white blood cells or WBCs. They are also known as soldiers of our body.
The soldiers of our body? Why is that?
What do the soldiers do?
They protect our country.
Yes. Similarly, the white blood cells, also known as the WBCs, help our body fight with various diseases.
Oh, what happened, Sonu? Look, your finger is bleeding.
Nothing much. My finger got stuck in this shelf.
Come, let me apply some Dettol.
Didi, when we fall or because we get hurt, our blood starts oozing out. But after a while, it stops. But there is a formation of a clot there. Why does this happen?
There are another type of cells present in the blood known as platelets. The clot is formed because of their presence.
Friends, like we need good roads for transportation, similarly, how does our body conduct transportation of various constituents?
We had read in the chapter on respiration that oxygen is transported by the blood and it also carries the carbon dioxide and undigested food too.
Very good observation, Rama. The blood conducts transportation with the help of the blood vessels. These blood vessels are known as arteries and veins. Look here in this poster. These red arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from the heart to all parts of the body. And these blue-colored veins carry carbon dioxide-rich blood from all parts of the body to the heart.
In this poster, the arteries are seen to be further dividing into smaller vessels.
Yes, children. On reaching the tissues, they further divide into thinner tubes known as capillaries. The capillaries join up to form veins which empty into the heart.
Didi, the heart does the most important job in our body. It keeps beating throughout the day. Can you please tell us about its functions?
Yes, sure, children, but I have to return back to the hospital now. You all try and remember all the information I have given you today.
Thank you, Dr. Didi.
The Dr. Didi gave such interesting information. All the children had become like doctors. All my questions were also answered. But I want to know, like Rama, that how does our heart keep beating without stopping for our whole lifetime? We will look for the answer to this question in the next video. We shall meet soon, friends. Transportation in Animals and Plants, Part 2. Hello friends, have you ever felt your heart beating? When we walk fast or run, we can listen to our heart beating rapidly. Keep your hand on your heart and feel the heartbeat on your own. Can you hear the heartbeat? Do you know, friends, our heart beats around 1 lakh times in a day. It is very hardworking. But how does our heart beat without stopping for our entire life? Come, let us find out about the heart and its functions through this video. The objectives of this video are 1. To understand what is pulse. 2. To know how does our heart work.
Sonu, come. We have to go and meet the doctor. I'm not feeling well.
Yes, mother. Let us go.
Hello, doctor. I have body ache and fever.
I shall do your checkup and find out about it.
Doctor, what do you try and find out by touching the wrist of the patients?
Sonu, I try and find out if the heart of the patient is working fine.
How do you find it out by just placing your fingers on the wrist?
Look here, Sonu. Keep your middle and third finger of the right hand on the inside of the wrist of your left hand. Can you feel a throbbing sound?
Yes, I can hear it. What is this throbbing sound, doctor?
This is known as our pulse. It is due to the blood flowing in the arteries. A person at rest has a normal heartbeat of 70 to 80 per minute.
Oh, when I run, my heart beats very rapidly. So does the pulse rate also become fast?
Yes, Sonu, you are right.
You can listen to the heartbeat with this stethoscope also.
Yes, Sonu, come here. This stethoscope helps to listen to the heartbeat.
Oh yes, can listen to my heartbeat. But doctor, how does the heart beat? It is a very rhythmic sound.
Ma'am, I think Sonu will become a doctor when he grows up. Sonu, the walls of the chambers of the heart are made up of muscles. This rhythmic contraction followed by a relaxation constitutes a heartbeat.
Our heart is so hardworking. It keeps beating throughout our life.
Sonu, I have organized a camp tomorrow in my clinic. Doctors are going to give information on heart and its functions, etc. If you want, you can come with your friends and gather information.
I will definitely come with my friends. Thank you, doctor.
Ma'am, you are absolutely fine. You just have weakness. I am writing a few medicines for you. Sonu, make sure your mother gets some rest.
Thank you, Doctor.
We shall meet tomorrow, Sonu.
Ramesh, Geeta, the doctor had said that we shall be able to gather a lot of information about body systems.
I am very excited.
Hello, Doctor.
Hello, children. Come look. There are various specialists here. You can go and collect information about any body system from them.
Look, there is a blood donation camp. Look, there is such a big picture of the heart. Let us go there. Hello, Doctor. Can you give us some information about the heart?
Yes, children. Sure.
What is this picture telling us about the heart?
Children, this picture is telling us about the functions of the heart.
Can you please tell us about it? We cannot understand much from the picture.
Sure, children. First tell me, where is the heart situated in the body?
Our heart is located in the chest cavity in the rib cage, slightly tilted towards the left.
Doctor, what will happen if the oxygenated blood and the deoxygenated blood gets mixed in the heart?
This is a very good question. For this situation not to arise, there are four chambers in the heart. Come, I will explain to you about this with the help of this poster. The heart is a two-story building. The upper two stories are called atrium. Look, left atrium and right atrium. There are two floors in the lower floor also. These are known as ventricle. Look, left ventricle and right ventricle. There is a door-like valve between the ventricle and the atrium. Because of this valve, the oxygenated and deoxygenated blood do not get mixed up.
Can you please tell us how the heart functions?
Have you ever seen a pump?
Yes, we have seen.
The heart works like a pump. By the help of this pump, blood reaches to all the parts of the body and comes back to the heart.
We had read that while going from the heart, the blood carries with it oxygen and nutrients. And while coming back, it becomes impure as it has carbon dioxide in it.
Absolutely right.
And there are blood vessels to bring the blood to and from the heart.
Yes, there is a network of these blood vessels in our body. Look, children, the blood from the upper parts of the body, like from the head, etc., comes into this upper tube, and from the stomach and lower parts of the body, the blood comes to this tube in the lower part. In the right atrium, there is a valve which opens only on one side. This valve will also open when the right ventricle will expand. Then the deoxygenated blood will have come in the ventricle and the valve behind it would have closed.
It means that it will not open back?
Yes, you are right. But there is another valve which opens from the right ventricle when the ventricle will shrink. Then, like paste comes out of a tube, similarly, the blood will come out of the right and left side of the pulmonary artery.
But this is going into the lungs?
Yes, the pulmonary artery takes the deoxygenated blood to the lungs.
But arteries carry oxygenated blood.
Yes, but only the pulmonary artery carries deoxygenated blood.
We had read in the chapter on respiration that there are many tiny blood vessels in the lungs which help in purifying the blood.
Yes, and now the blood is purified in the lungs. And this oxygenated blood comes back from the lungs to the heart and pulmonary vein carries it into the left atrium, into the heart. There is a valve present here also which opens only on one side. When the ventricle will expand, then the oxygenated blood will enter the ventricle. And when the ventricle will shrink, then the blood will go out of the valve. There is artery here known as the aorta, which carries oxygenated blood to all the parts of the body.
Our heart does a lot of hard work. We should really take care of our heart.
Yes, children. We all should eat a balanced diet, do exercise and take care of our heart.
Yes, our heart takes good care of us, so we should also take care of it.
Doctor, like carbon dioxide and other waste is also extracted through the help of the blood?
Yes, children.
I think I have gathered enough information on our heart for today. I will first go and write down all the information.
Yes, children, you have gathered enough information for today.
Thank you, Doctor.
So, did you see, children? Our heart is such a strong and hard-working organ. It beats continuously. Now you take care of your heart. We shall meet soon. Animals and Plants, Part 3. Hello friends, it is such a problem. If we drink water, there is a problem. If we do not, there is still a problem. You must be thinking, what problem? The same old going to the bathroom, looking for a bathroom. So many times there is no bathroom at some places. Children, elderly all face this problem. How is urine made? Which part of our body makes it? I have heard that not urinating frequently leads to a lot of diseases. Let us look for the answer to these questions through this video. The objective of this video are 1. To understand excretion in animals. 2. To understand the human excretion system. Today, Meenu and Shyam are going to the town with their father. There is an exhibition in the town on mobile toilets. Shyam and Meenu's father has to gather information about them. With the help of mobile toilets, the farmers will be able to use the bathrooms and not defecate in the open. It will also prove to be hygienic. Come, let us also visit the town with them.
Didi, can you please pass me the water bottle? I'm very thirsty.
Here, take this. But remember, if you keep drinking water, you will have to go to the bathroom.
Children, the bus will stop here for some time. Let us all rest for some time. Why don't all of us use the bathroom?
Look, Didi, that child urinated in the bus itself. Isn't it dirty?
He's a little child. He would not have been able to control his urine. But do you remember, Shyam, last year when we had gone to watch that film, you were drinking a lot of cola. You had to go to urinate urgently.
Oh, Didi, don't make me remember that. I feel very embarrassed.
I remember. The film was getting very interesting and you had to go urgently to the bathroom. But you wanted to watch the movie and then I hope you remember what happened.
Yes, I remember.
So the same incident should not be repeated. So go and use the bathroom.
Oh, there is such a long queue. I always control my urine. And the same thing happens with me. Ramu, can I go to the bathroom before you? I really need to go urgently.
I need to go urgently too.
Please let me go. I will give some chocolates when we go back to the bus.
Okay, go.
Thank you. You saved me today.
Did you drink a lot of water?
Actually, I always postpone going to the bathroom. But it is astonishing that we will have to go again in some time. We drink water, then go to the bathroom. But how is urine made? Do you have any idea?
Do you remember the shape of the rajma beans?
Yes.
Mother had said that there are two kidneys in our body which look like rajma beans. They purify the blood.
Okay, so there is a strainer in our kidneys.
Yes, our kidneys work like strainers. Look like the tea vendor straining tea over there. Urine is just water. What is in it that we have to take it out of our body? It would be interesting to know all this.
Why don't we ask Father?
Yes, let us go.
Father, Didi was telling us that urine is made and filtered in our kidneys.
How come this conversation on urine today?
Uncle, Shyam had controlled urine for a long time. There was a long queue outside the bathroom. He requested me to let him go first and that he would give me a chocolate if I let him go. So he started talking about urine and kidneys.
Shyam, you usually control your urine. You should know that there are harmful components in the urine.
Harmful components? How, Father?
Children, when our cells perform their functions, certain waste products are released. These are toxic and need to be removed from the body like urea, ammonia, and uric acid.
Father, I had read that the waste products in our blood are removed with the help of kidneys.
Yes, Meenu. The process of removal of wastes produced by the cells is known as excretion, and the parts involved in it form the excretory system.
What are the parts in the excretory system?
Kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, and urethra.
When the blood is filtered in the kidneys, then what do the other parts do?
As the name suggests, the ureter would be taking the urine somewhere ahead.
Yes, you are right. When I visit the hospital with my granddad, at times, I observed a chart of the urinary system there. What have you observed in it? There are two kidneys on each side. There are two tube-like structures which come out of each kidney and move ahead to connect to a bag-like structure. There is another tube-like structure which has a hole.
Can you try to make a drawing of the same?
I can try.
Our excretory system is almost like this. The kidneys purify the deoxygenated blood and make the urine.
Urine is mostly made up of water, isn't it, Father?
Yes, children. Urine is composed of 95% water, 2.5% urea, and 2.5% other waste products.
I used to think that urine is made up of dirty yellow water.
Ew, Ramu!
Can you tell us something about the other parts of the excretory system, Father?
These are ureters. The urine flows through them in the urinary bladder. It is collected in the bladder. It is stored in the ureteric bladder and is passed out through the urinary opening at the end of a muscular tube called urethra.
Wow! Our urinary system is no less than a factory.
That is why it is important to urinate at frequent intervals and at the correct places like a bathroom.
I had read in the newspaper that the Prime Minister of our country started the Swachh Bharat Abhiyan. We should also extend our helping hand towards it.
Yes, That is why father is going to the exhibition to find out about the mobile toilets, because of which our village will become cleaner.
It is also important to drink adequate water. My teacher has said that we should drink at least 8 glasses of water in a day.
Then I will keep sitting in the bathroom.
I'm feeling very thirsty.
Yes, you're sweating a lot too.
Isn't sweating also a part of excretion?
Crying also is a way of water secretion from the body.
Yes, and the tears are so salty.
Did you drink tears?
Oh, isn't it that sometimes when we cry, the tears get inside our mouth? The sweat is also salty.
That means that tears and sweat are both made up of salt and water.
Very good, children. Sweat is made of salt and water and helps to keep our body cool.
That means that I am cool now. Where are you going, Shyam?
I need to use the bathroom again. I do not want to delay this time.
So friends, I hope you learned that our excretory system functions efficiently. Kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder and urethra together form the excretory system. It is important to urinate at frequent intervals. We should also extend our help in the Prime Minister's Swachh Bharat mission. Now we shall meet in our next video, friends. Transportation in animals and plants.
Hello friends, I know all of you like riddles, so let me ask you a few riddles. Go and call your friends also, it will be a lot of fun. So tell me, I am big at places and small at some. I give you fresh air, I give you food too. Guess who am I? Come on, think. I am a plant. This next riddle is a little difficult. There are 5 alphabets in my name. Everyone likes my fruit. There are a lot of varieties of mine. There is a big seed inside me. Think and tell me. Mango. Isn't it fun? Come on now, guess the answer to this last riddle. I am the regional fruit of Kerala. There are 7 alphabets in my name. The outer layer of this fruit is very hard. The one who breaks it is very strong. Could you think? Coconut. Friends, did you recognize me? I am Podmal. Why are all of you laughing? I also have a name. These are my friends. We are of various kinds. Big, small, or huge, like the trees. I am feeling very hungry. And it is a very hot day today. I am thirsty too. You would be thinking that do plants also need food and water? All of you must have studied that the green leaves in plants make food by the process of photosynthesis. Similarly, it is important to transport food to the other parts of the plant. To remain alive, we need water also, otherwise we will wither away. But have you ever thought about how we drink water? We do not have any glass or straw. Let us find about the answers to such question from this video.
The objective of this video is to understand how transport occurs in plants.
Geeta and Ramesh stay with their parents in this house. Their mother is really fond of plants. Look, their garden is so beautiful and green. She really takes good care of us. She waters us on time, provides manure, keeps us in adequate sunlight. Yes, I am also a plant in their garden. Come, let us go inside their house. Let us find out to what mischief Geeta and Ramesh are up to today. You know, Ramesh is very naughty. He is always troubling Geeta.
Ramesh, look, I have kept a few flowers in the flower vase. You keep your ball away from it. If it falls, then I will complain to father.
Wow, these are such beautiful white flowers. Mother, mother, where are you? Look, my pen isn't working.
Oh, Ramesh, the way you are shaking your pen, if some ink spills by mistake and stains the wall, then father will get very angry. Look now, the ink has spilled. Weren't we scared of the same thing? Now quickly go and get a mop. Let us quickly wipe it.
Didi, look, the water in the flower vase has also become red. It looks like a few drops of the red ink fell in the water too.
Oh no!
Children, come and eat your dinner. You have to go to school tomorrow. Eat quickly and go to sleep.
Let us go, Ramesh. We shall look at this later.
Did you notice, friends? The water in the flower vase became red. What do you think? What will happen till the morning? We shall find out in the morning.
Children, get up. It is morning. Get ready soon.
Oh, how have the stem and the petals turned red? Ramesh, come here quickly.
What happened, Didi? Why are you shouting in the morning?
Ramesh, look at this.
Oh yes, how did this happen? How did the petals become red?
Do you remember, yesterday because of your mischief, a few drops of the red ink had fallen into the vase?
Yes, yes, I remember. But how did this red color travel to the flower? Did a magician come here last night?
Shall we take the flower vase to school? We shall show it to all our friends. Maybe we are able to find out the reason.
Friends, I am sure you're astonished. The ink which had leaked from Ramesh's pen got mixed with the water in the vase, because of which water became red. The whole night the stems of these flowers had kept their factory open. In the factory, the red colored water was pulled up by the stems. Come, let us find out how do the children solve this riddle.
Geeta, why have you brought the flower vase to school?
Oh, how have the petals of the white flower become red? Friend, this is a magical flower.
Oh, Ramesh, no friends. Actually, what had happened was that a few drops of red color had dropped in the water in the vase. When I saw it in the morning, the petals and the stems had become red.
I think that the white flower likes the color red.
It could be that this flower would be thinking that this red colored water is Ruavza and it would like it, so it must have drank it up.
I think this thought of drinking water is right. It could be that the stem of this flower would have pulled in the red water and would have supplied water to the whole plant.
Yes, like the green leaves make food for the plant by process of photosynthesis. Similarly, the stems help in transportation of water.
The children have guessed a few things.
Children, what is going on? What is this, Geeta? It looks like an experiment of transportation of water in plants. Children, the vascular tissue present in the plant for the transportation of water and food in plants is known as xylem. All of you collect information about this and bring it. Come on, children, open your books.
Anyways, Ramesh, due to your mischief, we got to learn something new. But I want to know more about this topic. Come, let us quickly go home and then we can go to the library and find out more information.
Friends, look at these tall trees. Have you ever wondered that how does water reach upwards in such tall trees? Think about it.
Didi, look, a juice vendor is standing near the house. Come, let us drink some juice. Didi, looking at this flower vase, a lot of questions are cropping in my mind. Look at these tall trees. Like these flowers in the vase suck the water due to the xylem in their stems. Similarly, what would be the process in these trees? Do they also have xylem which helps them to transport water so high up?
It is astonishing, Ramesh. Like we just now drank juice with the help of this straw, it could be that these trees have straws or long pipes.
The question which Geeta and Ramesh asked is very nice. We just saw that both the children drank the juice with the straw, because of which the juice reached their mouth. Similarly, the suction takes place in plants and trees. The water absorbed by the roots travels from the root hair, reaches the cells and then the xylem.
Today we have to collect a lot of information about transportation in plants. Come Ramesh, let us go quickly as we have to go to the library too.
Yes, Didi, I'm very excited too.
Geeta and Ramesh are headed to the library. Friends, isn't it astonishing that there is transportation in plants too? Be it small plants or big trees, to stay alive, we need food and water too. You all also try to do an experiment like this. Also, collect information about transportation in plants. We give you food, fresh air, flowers, shade on hot sunny days, and other things. We care for you and you care for us. I hope our friendship continues like this. Come on, you also go to the library with Geeta and Ramesh and collect a lot of information. Bye-bye, friends.